Hey, we're here with Robert C. Newman, who's running for governor, and he stands with you. He's for the legal protection of the unborn child. Can you tell me, sir, at what point does one become? What point does a fetus become a child? Do you believe?
A fetus become a child?
Yes.
It's a human being at conception. It's moot as to when it, the fetus through the embryonic development becomes a child. So it is a human being from conception.
So it, when the two subdivided cells are in fact a fetus, is that correct? That's a living child?
It's a living child at the time of conception, even before the first cleavage, even if it before it becomes a blastula and a gastula and implanted on in the uterine wall.
I see. So why do you why do you believe that there should be restrictions on abortion? Don't you think that people should be able to choose for themselves whether or not to have an abortion? Isn't this a democracy?
I think people who are responsible and understand the ramifications and the consequences of making an ill decision, I think they have to assume full responsibility for destroying a human life.
But they have the right to do that, right?
Which is created in God's image. I think they have the right.
You think they have the right to have an abortion?
Yes, I do.
Okay, that's good, because many people here don't believe they have the right to have an abortion.
I think people need to make sound decisions based on reason and the facts, and the long-term, as I said, ramifications, the consequences to their body, to the possibility of not being able to reproduce in the future, and the possibility of cancer, particularly of breasts.
Out of a million women that have abortions, how many do you think are no longer able to reproduce?
I have no data with respect to that particular
because issue. I've never heard that before.
Okay.
And I haven't met plenty of women at abortions, but I've never met one who couldn't reproduce because of that, although some of them might be happy if they couldn't. So go ahead.
You've made your statement.
Go ahead. Go ahead, comment.
Most people do not understand what the possibilities are of that, of not being able to reproduce or cancer off into the future. They don't realize that we do take our risks in life, and perhaps that's one of them the woman needs to take. However, it did take a spermatozoa to fertilize that egg. She did not produce that. He did. The male.
So the male has rights because he fertilized her, you're saying?
I think that's entirely it.
You don't find that rather patriarchal?
I'm sorry?
You don't find that rather patriarchal? It's part of patriarchy.
I find that realistic. She could not have reproduced on her own. I find it realistic.
So what about if it's a... if it's your daughter and it's she's 14 years old and she's been raped, would you let her carry that child to term?
Yes.
You would, unquestionably. And what about if the doctor said she's not developed enough, it may result in her death to carry the child to term? Would you still carry the child to term?
I think individual women reproduce at 12, 13, 14, 15 in other nations. And I just talked to a woman 2 days ago in a restaurant who is my server in Spanish and in English, but her Spanish wasn't sufficient to carry on a complete conversation. She has friends. She's in her early 30s now, getting her formal education. She has friends still in Mexico who started reproducing at age 12 and 13 and 14. What age was Mary, who conceived of the Holy Spirit and gave birth to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
So do you believe Mary was a virgin?
What age was she when she was conceived of the Holy Spirit? I think maybe 14 or 15.
Well, we don't know. There's no historical evidence that there was a Jesus, so we don't actually know if any of that is true.
You don't actually know. I know intellectually, I know in my heart that Jesus Christ was born of a virgin.
Okay. To change the subject, besides your anti-abortion stand, what other stance do you have with state government? What would you do differently than Jerry Brown does if you were governor?
I don't think there's very much that I agree with Jerry Brown on as our current governor, who's all washed up in November of this year, when I replace him as the current candidate for governor, the pro-life candidate for governor. There's not too much that we agree on with respect to taxation, with respect to representation, with respect to regulations, with respect to sanctity of life.
I see. So,
any of his positions in that regard, but that's not the reason I'm.
How about you? How about you believe in catastrophic climate change, or do you believe it's a myth?
I believe. I'm a research clinical psychologist. I got my PhD in research clinical psychology. I have, in the past, read the literature, and climate change used to be climate cooling, and then it became climate warming. And now it's climate change. It is, in fact, please quote me on this, it is based on pseudoscience, false science, not empirical science.
Thank you very much, sir.